Hi everyone, and welcome back to Res 2016. It is now day two, and we're kicking it off with Void 21.
Hello.
Welcome.
Thank you very much.
The first thing I usually ask people to do is if you could give us a brief description on your game, and then I can follow up with whatever.
Sure thing. So Void 21 is a procedurally generated runner and shooter. We took inspiration from games like Raise the Sun Distance, and then combined them with the shooter experience from games like Jets and Guns or the old, very old Tyrion classic. Right. And what we wanted to do is give this experience where anybody can choose whether they want to go for it really fast and really, you know, just racing, or if they wanted to go violently and destroy everything in their path. And that's right. Pretty much what we would obtain out of it.
Right, so is this like challenges against like a computer, or is it other players?
So there's free game modes. There is the daily run, which basically generates 30 different sections, right. And they generate them based on the date, and everybody gets the same exact types of levels. So what ends up happening is people can compete based on their points and time on finishing the levels, and you know, it resets every day. Right, there's the endless mode and endless runner challenge, which is literally go as far as you can without dying. If you die, back at the beginning. And then there's the seed picker, so if you particularly like a specific section or you just wanted to do something over and over again to train, you can just pick that up, type it in. And also we have like secret seeds in there that, for example, one of them is called Boom Boom, and you just get bombers constantly blowing you up. You have to avoid all their bombs or shoot them down.
Alright, so you mentioned bombers. I take it that's like a type of enemy?
Yes.
So how many different enemies are there that you've got to look out for?
So far there are 30 different types of enemies that get unlocked as you gain experience in the game. So right, you start off with one and it just progresses you through all of them. Eventually, because we're kind of developing as we're going along, we're going to have 100 different types of enemies, and we also have the ship is customizable, so the guns you have get unlocked as you progress, and they get become more and more powerful.
Right, yeah, I was just going to say that there's more enemies, I'm assuming there's bigger and badder guns that you can get for your ship. Right, so I take it you can level up your offense from the new weapons and stuff like that. Is there any defensive ways? So like, if you say if you want to go pure speed, is there a way that you can defend against the people that
are
going to be
attacking? Yes, so there are, right now, on the lower levels, there are some shield modules, that basically absorb one or two impacts. Right. You can choose to equip two shield modules, but that would mean you have to not equip something like a jump module that comes in very handy for avoiding stuff, or a time warp module that slows down time so you can do more precise maneuvers and stuff like that. So it's a very bit of a strategy in how you want to progress through each seed. And some of them will not allow you to progress with the modules you have, so you have to go and change them before you actually are able to finish it.
So like, is there like certain challenges where it's like you can't use a jump in this one and you can't?
Yeah. Well, you can. It's just gonna be a bad idea because there are some where there's a lot of sky enemies that just get in your way. So if it's probably a better strategy. Just sit down, go low, and let all the enemies pass by instead of jumping into them and destroying yourself.
Right. So just jumping back to earlier, you mentioned like all the free game modes that you've got in. Yeah. Just what's your personal favorite out of those three?
Personally, I love the daily run mainly because it keeps it fresh on a day-to-day basis, but it allows you not only for good training but good competition against everybody else.
Right.
You just basically can go on the leaderboard and just look at it and be like, all right, that's what people have done. Maybe I can do better. Or you can just share it with your friends and be like, hey,
not bad idea. Alright, that's brilliant. So just to finish off, is there anything you'd like to say to people who are wanting to get their hands on the game or try it out for themselves?
Two things. So it's right now out on Steam. It came out 3 days ago, and there is a demo version. So if you want to just try it out without making any commitments, that's fine. Go on Steam, download the demo, and you can play that for, well, we have 8 hours of content. There is no time limit. You can play for as much as you want, but you might get bored after about 8 hours. So just grab the full version if you like it.
Alright, that's brilliant. Well, thank you very much for coming over.
Thank you very much for having us.
No worries.